Well, as we begin the huge task of mass vaccinating Queenslanders against COVID-19, not everyone is on board. People are still asking, just how safe is the jab? Do we really need to get it? Well, tonight we're looking into your urgent concerns with top virus expert, University of Queensland virologist, Dr. Kirsty Short. Dr. Short, it is the most fast-tracked vaccine in the world. So how safe is it? We've been gauging people's concerns out on the streets. Let's take a listen.
Our main concern would be, you know, the reports on the AstraZeneca people getting blood clots.
This is the big talking point at the moment. Are people right to be worried?
This is really not a point of concern. So actually, when you go back and look at the clinical trials from AstraZeneca, they looked in about 24,000 people, and of those that had the vaccine, 4 people had a blood clot. Of those that didn't have a vaccine, 8 had a blood clot. So it's really not necessarily associated with the vaccine and could just be this background rate.
Let's have a listen to this one from Anne Marie.
Hi, my name's Anne Marie, and my main concern about the COVID vaccine is long-term effects and what might happen down the track for us if we have that vaccine.
I think a lot of people share Anne Marie's concern, but what we've got to remember is that in the whole history of vaccination in the human population, we've never had a vaccine that has had long-term consequences.
I think that it just hasn't been tested for long enough before it's put onto the market.
Dr. Short, have we rushed this vaccine through?
No. All the normal safety checks have been performed and they have not been accelerated. What has been accelerated is the manufacturing process, and that's been enabled because we've just invested so much money into this.
What about health workers, for example, experiencing anaphylactic shock?
Anaphylaxis is always a risk of any treatment, but there's no reason to suggest that an individual who's never had anaphylaxis before would suddenly develop anaphylaxis with this vaccine.
Doctor, when we went out on the street, we found there's definitely some apprehension out there.
I'm a very healthy old lady and I take no medications and I never catch anything, so I'm not getting it.
Look, the reality is that everybody is vulnerable to this virus, and the only way that you can protect yourself is to get vaccinated.
It's clear there's still a lot of concern about the vaccine and pregnancy.
Yeah, I have a pregnant friend. She has a little bit of concern about, you know, whether you should lay off or not, or having the shot or not.
We're not actually sure what the effect of the vaccine is in pregnant women. But the good news is that during the clinical trials, some women did become inadvertently pregnant and they were fine and their babies were fine.
Now, this is a concern for a lot of older people in the community.
Is it going to affect my already health issues and the medication that I'm taking?
Look, the important thing to remember is in all the clinical trials of these vaccines, there was a diverse patient population used. So lots of people were taking various medications and they saw no detrimental effects.
Dr. Short, you work closely with the virus. Have you been vaccinated?
I received my first shot of the vaccine. I'm due for my next shot next week. And I can tell you that my arm was a little bit sore after having the vaccine, but that was it. No problems.
And you're confident that, generally speaking, the community should be quite at ease with this whole process?
I believe in following the data, and the data tells us that everybody should feel confident in the safety and the efficacy of these vaccines.
Dr. Short, hopefully we've allayed some of those fears and busted some of the vaccine myths. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.